Welcome Tommy He to have a speech about a life of translator.
Okay, great. Good afternoon. My name is Tommy He, and I'm going to present the topic of life of translator. So if you're really passionate about movies, just like me, you can tell that this movie kind of, this name comes from the similar to the life of Pi, which is, I think it is the Chinese translation of this movie is really great. It's about 少年派的奇幻漂流. It is not a literary translation of the words, because if it is, it will be really boring. So my topic in Chinese would be 翻译者的开源社区之旅. Okay. A little bit about myself. I'm kind of the early adopter of Linux from 2001, and I've become a user of Fedora since Fedora Core 4. I'm also the editor of the open source website called linuxtry.org. I'm also, during my free time, I am passionate about the transition work, so I'm kind of work on many different apps. The simplified Chinese translation, including Shellwell, the Photoshop Manager, and the SMPair, and the Azores, the BitTorrent downloader. I'm also one of the contributors for the Fedora project as a translator, as a tester. And also, recently, I think in 3 years ago, I was become an ambassador for the Fedora. Also, I'm kind of involved in the events organized for the Fedora offline activities. During my free time, I love to take photos and I call myself a photographer, but yeah, this small baby costs nearly 4 months of my salary. Right, so in today's topics, I'm going to tell something about history and experiences. So first it's about history of FD, which is literally means Fedora Chinese user group. We have a very short history, but it's rarely talked about, so I would like to take this opportunity to let you guys know about it. It's partly because of, I mean, we are a kind of user group, so we got people come and people go. Unfortunately, a very few members of early a few people who are early members still remain within this group. Sad story, but yeah. Also, I'm going to talk about a little bit about Linux and Fedora in China. In fact, Java, but also Linux in China face a great challenge here, which doesn't seem to come often in the other regions. It's partly because we are not competing with preparatory or proprietary OS. It's not just Windows. We are also competing with pirated copies here. So, yeah. We're also going to see these things from a new respect from the eyes of the eyes of the translator. Also, I'm going to share some tips and experiences about localization, but I'm going to talk a bit about the tools I used in those past years. But for the real techniques, I welcome you guys to participate to the workshop tomorrow afternoon. It's hosted by the Fedora Chinese localization group, Tian Shixiong. He's I think he got a title of coordinator, means he kind of coordinates all of our efforts on the part of the localization. Okay. Back to 2001. What happened in that time? Well, for me, I was just playing around. I mean, that's my first time to use Linux. So during that time, it was PC or a personal computer just start become popular in China. There are two reasons for that. I mean, as you may know, that the gaming consoles was always, has always been considered as illegal in China for the past decade, always since the beginning. So the PC becomes the only way for Chinese people to play electronic games. And because the interest of games, so there are many net cafe setups in China. It's I mean, if you are living somewhere near a campus or a middle school, you can find a net cafe every 1 kilometer. This is pretty intense. And we also facing a problem here in China is we got pirated copies. Well, I think that's part of the reason of our flawed copyright law, which said that you are free to use any software for the educational purpose within 24 hours. You do not need to consult the copyright owners of that as long as you are for the educational purpose. But hey, that's a flaw. I mean, nobody could check whether you are using it for the educational purpose or your just personal own interest. So, right. But also the problem here is that in 2001, there are kind of borrowing DRM technology called StarForce, which is even making the legal users of a certain piece of software tend to use pirated copy because it's much simpler. Well, we also get some, as the picture shows here, we also get a lot of Chinese government sponsored, obviously, Linux distributions here. You can see that there are Bluepoint, there is a Happy Linux, which is developed by the Lenovo. I think who is currently the number one PC sellers in the world. We got Red Flag, which is got as the beginning of this year. So why those Chinese sponsored Linux distribution happens? It's partly because that in this year there is law enforcement said that obviously the law regulation there says that you cannot sell barebone PC. Every PC sold in the market must have US pre-installed. But in order to reduce the cost, so those PC manufacturers tend to use those free Linux as their pre-installed OS. Even they could get some tax deduction during because of this, because they were kind of promoting Chinese operating system. Okay. So, what happened? What happened after Fedora Core 4? That's the first Fedora release I have ever used. When I first meet that, I'm get impressed by this look. I think that's also the first time people say clear looks. It's the name of the GDK2 themes, which from my personal thought, I think it's the best of the GDK2 theme. And it's cool, but I was also confused by the SC Linux. Fedora Core 4 was also the first to have SC Linux enabled by default. It covers many of domains, so sometimes it makes your regular desktop usage annoying. But even though that, I grew my fond of this Linux distribution and start to say goodbye to the dubus. I completely ditch out Windows from my hard drive and stick to Linux up to now. So later I become the missionary for the Fedora and free open source software. I started to burn DVD and distribute it to people I know, people around me, or other people who asked me to help to install pirated copies to their PC. In that case, I was like, hey, why not give Fedora a try? It's not pirated copy, it's free. But yeah, but in that time, I only know that free as beer. You can see here, the picture here is also my first contribution to the open source software. It's the translation of this MPUI. Its name is It's a graphic front end for the Ampere on Windows. One reason is that because Ampere, back to that time, Ampere is the only media player who can play XVID on one single core computer. So I think it's cool. So I made it, I helped to translate it into Chinese. What's happening 2 years later? 2 years later, Fedora 7 was released and I call it Core Dump because it says the release with Fedora dumped the name of Core. It's kind of, we gotta have one unified repository. We got open development for the for control by the community. We don't have such kind of the line between core and actual. That's just what Fedora. It's also the first Linux distribution shipped with KVM enabled. I believe all of you guys know KVM, right? That's a kind of the foundation of the modern virtualization technology here. And we got a tickless kernel, which makes my laptop could run at least 2 hours without draining all the juice. What happened to other Linux in China? Well, back in that time, we got Ubuntu. It's an actually gains people's attention. One reason is that Ubuntu started to distribute free CD worldwide to anyone who applied. Free CD, cool. So people come. People tend to use Ubuntu because it has free CD delivered to their door. And they also have another one big advantage is that Ubuntu has a local repository. So what's that mean? It means that if you download a pack of software from their repository, they were fast and they were reliable without dump. I can still remember back in that time using YAM to download one package from in Fedora, it took hours. Average speed is about 5 to 15 kilobits per second, which is painful. What's others? Some unique problem I think only happens for the Linux distributions in the Asian field is that we got to deal with the problem of input method. Back to that time, we got FCATX, sometimes maybe known familiarly called Xiaoqi'e术法. And we also got the other old one, it's called SCAM. They were not, none of them are perfect. They got problem, especially for the FCATX, because they are the also for the FCATX decided to desist from community activity, stop development. Well, so we got problem for the Chinese users. Well, for myself, I think that's the first time I no longer call myself a newbie for the Linux. I start to gain confidence of myself for the stuff related to the Linux. One reason, maybe two reasons here, as it lists is, first, don't be a distribution switcher. I see many of the newcomers to the Linux try to decide which distribution fits their own work, fits their best. They tend to install maybe Fedora in the January, and they switch to Ubuntu in the February, and maybe in the for March they will try to Arch Linux. This is not good. This is not going to help you to get familiar with the Linux as an operating system. Somebody pointing fingers. Is that you? Oh yeah. All right. Okay. Well, the other way to get to being confident about Linux is just try LFS at least one time. It is really good helpful to get you to understand what really happens after all these fancy GUIs, after all those what are those background processes do. So if you don't know what LFS means, it stands for the Linux from scratch. This is a really good piece of learning material. I strongly recommend it. Well, so 1 year later, it's 2008. There is, for the Chinese people here, you're probably going to remember this year as a year for the Olympic Games in Beijing, but there's other things also important happens. So, in that year, Fedora 9 released, it's called Shelfer. This is also the first time for the Fedora release has a fully translated release note. I'm very glad to tell that it is by me. I spent 10 hours on that and I have uploaded to the Linux Tri. So I cannot have a time advantages because during that time I was living in a small town near Sydney. So I got time zone advantage here to be the first. Also, in Fedora 9, we got IBUS, which is intelligence bus. It's intelligence input method framework. So we still have hope for the Chinese user because hey, we were not abandoned from the Linux distributions. Also start become a contributor in that year. Started to involve to the local user group activities. I met someone in my university and he introduced me a lot more about what free open source software means. It's not just the meaning for the free, it's not just free as beer, it also means free as your
free speech.
Yes, free as speech. And right, okay. I'm also start to write some tutorials and the news on Linux.org. Oops. And also I'm started to be an official member of Fedora localization group. Well, in the later year 2008 is October 21st. Those Fedora Chinese user group setup. I for myself, I would say this is pretty late. We were already in a downhand in the competition with Ubuntu in China. So we got Kinetical has sponsored the forum to Ubuntu.com.ca. So the Chinese user in Ubuntu has one single place to share their experiences. So they have one single place for the developers to discuss, but not such thing until this happens for the Fedora. So what I would call, so it's finally a home for the Fedora users in China. My personal feeling, I'm not sure whether you guys have saw the X-Men. So for me, it's feeling that we are mutants, and we finally found the Xavier's gifted children's school, right? That's my personal opinion. So, what's after? After the Fedora Chinese user group set up, the whole community in China grows. So we literally have some Chinese write apps for Fedora. One is called Alusas, and for the left hand side, it's the screenshot of this app called Alusas. The name of this application is a little bit weird, but it actually means red panda. Not funny, okay? Yeah, it's also a generic tweak tool similar to the Ubuntu tweak, if you know that. We also have another help by the FDUG community. It's called Kernel Helper. It's a graphic configuration tool for the kernel configuration. the sad story that none of those apps survived today. Kernel Helper didn't have future release, and Alusias were simply turned to the other directions. Even though this community, I would say the Chinese user group, have some action taken. First, we try to find local mirrors, which we all agree that that should be the top priority. We, as contributor for Fedora in China, should resolve here. I'm not sure whether there is any red hat guy here, but yeah, I would say that we received very limited support from red hat Beijing office. We're kind of disappointed here. So, well, I don't know why, but they were not that reluctant to help. So now, if you are a Fedora user in China, when you try to YAML, it's actually getting packages from the mirrors sponsored by NetEase, not Red Hat. Okay, yeah. We also can't help to have Red Hat legal guys on the trademark dispute. It's a story. Let me say I will try to briefly say that. Between someone kind of cooperative with Red Hat Beijing back to 2007, and they tried to distribute the city images of Fedora, and somehow Fedora Beijing let those guys to register the Fedora logo. So it's funny that Fedora doesn't own the logo, Red Hat doesn't own the logo of Fedora in China. It's owned by the other company. So during that time, I put a note on the Linux Twine and sent a list to the on the forum so that people could work together to find some materials in China before 2007. Kind of evidence to prove that this logo, this Fedora logo, belongs to us, not those third party company. What else? Yeah. Later this year, we do have set up the mailing list for the Chinese group. It's just called Chinese. It doesn't distinguish between either you speak simplified Chinese or traditional Chinese. It's just Chinese. This is one mailing list for all the Chinese peoples. And I think that's a brilliant idea, because that could bring up some many things later. Many good things later I will explain. So we also have some debate within the Chinese Fedora Chinese user group. During that time, there are also Fedora themed forums in China. One is called FedoraChina.org. Sometimes it's got distract people who want to reach the contributors of Fedora, want to reach the Fedora contributors in China. They were misled, I would say. But we don't have a great opinion among the contributors on how to deal with FedoraChina.org. We were kind of having a furious debate back to that time. Eventually, they die. We survive. Well, we also have some challenges here. It's funny that as the first year of the Fedora Chinese user group setup, their founding members were 7. Four of them don't live within China. So we only got 3 people in China, and the rest of the guys were living outside China. So this separation, this geography separation, made us really difficult to organize offline events. It just can't happen if you don't have people in China, right? Are you from Red Hat? No? Okay. Right. What I was doing, but at that time I'm writing hundreds of news and tutorials on Linux Twine. Some were my personal piece of work is like Fedora 9 on PlayStation 3 comparison between various lightweight desktop environments and some introduction to the SLIN Linux and a tutorial on how to convert your ext4 partition to btrfs without losing any data. I took my personal time experiment and write my tutorial on that. I also spent a lot of time to translate it other news or progress, testing days, notifications, here. Well, yeah, that was updated constantly, so it's daily basis. You can get the it's kind of the heartbeat of the Fedora community in Chinese. Well, I'm also actively participating in every bit of Fedora transition, including application, the web, the documentation, the wiki. I completely reworked the Chinese translation for the Anaconda, the Fedora in the installer for the Fedora. I also completely reworked the printer system-config.printer, and also I one hand doing the translation for the SE Linux troubleshooter. I also spend my time with some other non-Fedora apps for the simplified Chinese translation, including Aston SO2, it's a CD image manipulator, and also a Linux music jukebox called Music Q. It's all my work. Also, if you still remember that the time between Fedora 14 release, the website of Fedora has a completely rework. We changed a lot, so that was time between the end of 2010. So what I was doing in the Spring Festival in the 2011, I'm actually bring my laptop and carry download all the PO files for the new website. And if normally for the Chinese guys during the Spring Festival, they were celebrate how we failed the firecrackers to play around with your friend. But for me, I was completely devoted to the translation of Fedora website. Well, sad and lonely. Yeah. Okay. But we do make some great accomplishments here. So if you guys attend this morning's Fedora section about Fedora Next, you see those. I think it will print out four foundations of Fedora: friends, freedom, first, friends, features. Those things were listed Chinese translations. They were kind of the group work of me and this guy Tian Xuxiong, our localization coordinator, and the rest of the Fedora Chinese group, which is great. Those times were not easy because we were those transition work was somehow held back by the tools we have. Back to the time of 2011, the transition infrastructure was hosted by the Fedora infrastructure team. This is an old instance of Transifex. This is slow, and it sometimes causes problems. Sometimes it could be even bigger that you submit something and it just disappears. That's frustrating. So we will tend to use offline tools for the transition. One is pure edit. It is WX widget based tool. Sometimes I think back to that time it's WX widget 2.6. It is entirely unstable. So it's, and people, and for the newcomers to the translation, they sometimes get trapped to for the pure edit in the, for the form of plural form. You know that in English, there were some certain words end with S, means which was in the plural form, but in Chinese, it doesn't have that. You have to explicitly tell pure edit, hey, we are doing Chinese, we don't need plural form. Later, I personally came to find a pretty handful too. It's called Qwerty Qt Linguistic. It's Qt for, it's Qt 4 base, it's stable, but the downside of this tool is that you have to install entirely Qt development toolkit to only use this translation tool. Well, good thing is that at the year, at the end of 2011, we have that Fedora Activity Day. Right in this place, right on that stage, as may Jerry say, no, she's not, he's not here. Yeah, right in this place. So, it happens on November the 14th. This is a really big milestone for our, for the for the Fedora Chinese user group. Why? Before, we, our offline, like, offline activity is limited to the local release party. They were self-funded, so it means the automatics were paid by the paid from the pockets of the event organizer or the ambassador himself, and they were just a small scale cooperative, maybe with the local Linux group if they are exist. But from Fed 2011, we grew bigger. We kind of cooperated with Open Source Week with a guy from OS2, and we got great support from Red Hat APAC and the Beijing office. Back that time, we got Harish from Red Hat Singapore, fly here. That's the first time we have a speaker overseas to the local event of Fedora. We also have we also grew our skill for the release parties. Actually, the photo shows here, it's a release party for the Fedora 18 Beijing. But it's not just Beijing. For those release names as, I think it's Beefy Miracle, right? For the Fedora 18. Alright, that's 70, sorry. But yeah, for Fedora 18, we have release parties simultaneously. Beijing, Shanghai, Guangzhou, and Taichung, which is in Taiwan. So it's great. This is one of the benefits we have, one unified mailing list. Because not only simplified Chinese, obviously the users in mainland China, communities in that mailing list, the people in Taiwan, in Hong Kong, even in Singapore, communicate on this, using that mailing list. So we got a synchronized ideas around, so we could organize this thing as a global event, even for this small release party. So, during this time, we have an event process set up. We got the scheduling act here. We got budget proposal. We can call for paper. We got event organized, and after the event, we even sent a feedback survey. And I'm not sure whether CRISPR is here. And we also got our social media in China. Okay, the Weibo is actually our official media presence in China. That's all from 2011. And the good things for the translation here is that during that time, we got our Fedora infrastructure team was kindly enough to move the instance to the transifex.net. It makes all the work of as a translator a lot easier. It is, the new instance is fast and it is responsive. So it has cloud editor, it's autosave, it has glossary support. This is very intuitive for the newcomer to use. So if you are going to join our localization group, don't look those old offline tools. ever. Just use an online editor, the cloud editor provided by the TransFX. Well, what I was doing, I updated the old but new apps. You know that recently Anaconda got a huge rewrite, so that means all the translation work has to be redo, and for the ABRT, the automatic bug reporter too got reworked. It was separated into ABRT, the GUI side, and the LIB report, lib report for all the background stuff. That means all the translation has to be redo again. Well, I think this is new, because this rework gives myself and the rest of the translation people here an opportunity to self-improvement. We can see what we missed in the past, and we can have an opportunity to improve in this new release. The other thing is that we got some, for myself, I took the responsibility of two new apps in the Fedora. One is a firewall D, the dynamic firewall application in Fedora. I believe this in the other section, someone from our group is on an introduction for this app. And the other two is Entangle, which is, I feel weird. This if you are not familiar with Entangle, that is an app in your laptop which could control your camera. So if you connect your camera with your laptop, fire up Entangle, and you can take photos or change camera settings from your laptop, which is cool. But I don't know why this is considered as a core app for the Fedora. And I don't even know why it was never translated. So I did the job. In the other part, I was start to use the explore feature on the TransFX.net to find new applications to translate, which is cool. Normally, the translation, the localization is welcomed by the app author. You will just ask him politely, hey, do you want your app to be translated in Chinese? They always say yes. Hopefully in the future too. Well, I'm also trying to find translate some apps on the Android. Okay. Time for the translation next. You know that you're kind of in the era of the Fedora next, but for me, it's actually took one decade, and from a user of Linux to the Fedora contributor, then to the Fedora ambassador. I hope this time for you, for all the newcomers to the Fedora, don't have to take those slots. That's one purpose of me who presenting this topic here. Hope you could take a less time than me. So, why not being one part of us? It could be fun. So you kind of work with, in our group, you can work with people who speak with same languages. Languages as not just in Chinese, but also means you speak like with people who also using Fedora. We don't have any obligations. That's probably one of the reasons why people come and go. But yeah, you don't have to speak an oath like the next watch in the war. If you guys know that, okay. I see you smiling. All right, so your own contribution. You, there is no words. There is no obligation. But your reputation is gained by your contribution to this group. Well, also good, we are doing something good. It's you could share your knowledge with others, and you can also learn stuff from the others. We want people with different knowledge background. We don't want people in computer science or electronic engineering. We want any background. For instance, we always have problem translating the section of science in the release note, because there were few people who understand how those high speed particle collider works, so we don't know anything about energy physics, so that's the part we always always found headache. So if you are in that field, welcome to join us. We also have pretty respect of the foundations of Fedora, and we have you could, by being part of us, you could be a part of the history of how far a free open source Linux desktop can go, how far it can go in China. It's up to your hand, it's in your hand. And for the last, I think, I don't know where, so if you're any of them from England, I hear this word from, I think it's a charity group in England. Its slogan is that every little help. It's actually, literally means every little help. One bug report can help, just one word translation help can help. That's pretty much all, but for the end, I will tell you some secret tips on how to tell whether one is a translator or not. The first one is that if you find somebody who uses punctuations carefully in short messages or in tweets, he may probably be one of the translators. Or if found he were kind of a precisely to insert half-length space between between numbers and alphabets and Chinese, he might also be a translator. Or even say he is very sensitive to the letters with underline. He may be a translator. So, I think you guys can tell that I am a translator, right? That's all for my topic. So, any questions? Please. Okay.
Are you also on the GNOME documentation team? Translation team for Chinese.
Unfortunately, not. I'm the good friend with Arrow, so I just send back report to him, and he will fix the work.
Okay, you should come to my talk. You'll see why.
Ah, okay. So because you're also the sick group of the translator, right? Cool. All right. Please.
Okay. How did you get the Fedora logo back?
What?
How did you get the Fedora logo back?
Logo.
Logo.
Oh, logo back. I think it's actually I spent one trip back to Beijing. Pay a visit to the National Library, and I found a textbook back to 2006. It's about Fedora, and there is a small logo there. We also got some help with people with early collections of Fedora CDs. It's about 2005 and 2006, so we collect them together and send it to the Red Hat people group. So we were kind of get Fedora logo back.
I see some guys from Red Hat out there. You can go there and ask why.
Right, I know. I mean, actually, you know what? We were as somebody mentioned during the talk of the as this morning's topic, Fedora community don't live closer, obviously we have bond to the Red Hat, but we were not that close as somebody expect, or somebody outside the group expect. We have connection, but it's complicated, right? So, yeah, we kind of value our independence. So, there are good people back there, but yeah. Anyone? Please?
Just want to know that how many people in your community now? And how do you persuade other people to join your community?
Well, for the Chinese part, I believe the number never goes larger than 20. Never goes larger than 20. I mean, for the translation part, but we now got up extra hands for the marketing, for the packages, so the total number will be around 40. And what? Oh.
So how do you determine that the translation is correct?
Well, we got a process set up. So it's not everything. When you submit one translation on the Translifex, it will be reviewed by the senior members, which is you will probably me is one of the senior members, so I will review the translations, and if it's cool, if your translation was submitted to an entirely new app, it will be under a group peer review by the other translators. Please.
So, is there any so rules or so policy to communicate the federal team and upstream localization work, for example, the GNOME or for me, LibreOffice or something?
Oh, we do have very good relationship with GNOME localization.
Mm-hmm.
We will work closely, but I'm not sure if any of us participates for the LibreOffice part.
Mm-hmm.
We could discuss it later, so.
Okay.
Yeah. We got a relationship with LXDE. We have good relationship with those desktop environment localization group. But no, so far as I have no name for the labor office.
Okay. So short comment. So LibreOffice simplified Chinese translation works very, very well. So it's not a problem, but I just want to know the how you collaborate.
Okay.
Thing.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. It's to you. Anything else? So okay. I will stop here. Thank you guys.